This is a production of PBS 39.
Tonight's History Highlight spotlights the year 1932. In this newsreel, 3,000 people visit the White House to shake President Hoover's hand on New Year's Day. And housewives contribute food for families in need. A new Washington quarter was minted in Philadelphia, and the world's largest bomber was introduced to the public.
President's receiving today, and about 3,000 people have been standing in line for hours to wish Mr. Hoover a Happy New Year and give him a sore hand he'll remember for a week. And for 5 years, John Hunefield has been first in line. Today's no exception. The crowd doesn't figure that they only shake one hand, but the president has to squeeze 3,000 of them. It's a good thing it's raining, or there might have been 6,000 people on hand like there were at last year's reception at the White House. All the diplomats and cabinet members are on the job to greet the President and Mrs. Hoover, although there aren't many here from Congress to say hello to the Chief Executive and the First Lady. But of course, Congress is in recess now, and they're all scattered. Secretary of War Hurley and the lovely Mrs. Hurley are present. And the aged Mr. Mellon, Secretary of the Treasury, in spite of a bad cough. The grocery shop has taken on new importance. The women of the nation are on the warpath in a battle against starvation. They've adopted the Share-A-Meal plan, the scheme in which they buy, whenever they can, two of everything, one for themselves and one for the basket. The full baskets go to the packing stations, where they're prepared for distribution to the hungry unfortunates who need them. Incidentally, this part of the great plan provides employment for quite a few men. And no formalities. If your family's hungry, just come in and get it. About 5 tons of food a day. Not nearly enough. Go out to just such homes as this. And boy, is it welcome. Well, here's one place that's making money. New money out of old. They throw the worn-out coins in the furnace where they're melted almost immediately. Then the liquid silver alloy is poured into molds, and it comes out in the form of ingots, roughly about the width of a quarter. The rolling mill takes care of getting them down to the proper thickness under terrific pressure. All ready for the punching machine that knocks out the blank coins. The next operation is feeding the blanks into the stamping machine that mills the edges and stamps both sides of the coin at the same time, all ready for spending. The last word in sky fighting, the all-metal B-1. She's 52 feet long. Her total loaded weight's about 7 tons, and she can carry about a ton of bombs. This is her first public appearance. They've been keeping her a secret up till now. A rather startling surprise for anybody who might be interested. And in spite of her tremendous size, she's as easy to handle as a bicycle. It's really a flying fort at a speed of 200 miles an hour. Just one of the little aces the Army's keeping as a whole car.
And that brings us to tonight's Tempo Trivia question. Who was the first woman elected to the U.S. Senate back in 1932? The answer's coming up. Well, it's time for us to be in touch with the answer to our Tempo Trivia question. Who was the first woman elected to the U.S. Senate back in 1932? Well, it was Hattie Caraway of Arkansas. She was earlier appointed to fill the unexpired term of her late husband, Thaddeus Caraway. Here are some more interesting fast facts from 1932.
Support for Tempo is provided by
building a workforce system called PA CareerLink Lehigh Valley. Training the workforce to meet employer hiring needs. connecting employers with workers and workers with jobs. Lehigh Valley Workforce Investment Board.
Lehigh Valley Economic Development Corporation, helping business arrive, helping business thrive. Lehigh Valley Economic Development Corporation, contributing to the growth and success of the Lehigh Valley, one business at a time.
RCN and RCN4, partnering with PBS 39 and committed to bringing quality local television programming to the residents of the Lehigh Valley. RCN, cable, phone, and internet.
And by the members of PBS 39. Thank you.